in great detail the effect of this proviso, and while submitting that the principle captured under clause D is that the seats are to go to the political parties and not to the independents, with the only exception being the independents duly joining a political party. And the submission thus far made from the respondents is that such political party must have won one seat at least in the House. Now, if I may take you through the record, and yesterday I had also made a submission that while working out the share of each political party, the independents are excluded as provided in sub-rule 2 of rule 95, which is then read with rule 94 of the 2017 rules. So if I may take you first to 2018, which was the first election after the 2017 Act and the 2017 rules, and then I'll take you to the 2002 rules, the rules which were made to give effect to 51(6)(d), which was brought into the Constitution at that point in time. I'm taking you now to the paper book which I have placed before you, sir. Page 10 of this paper book. This is now the 2018 general election. This is with respect to the non-Muslim seats, the allocation of non-Muslim seats. My Lord would see that total number of seats are 10, still are. And if I may take you to the last row and then take you upwards. The grand total of the seats at that time was 272. On 3 seats, the elections were either postponed or stayed, so they were taken out of the equation. So we were left with 269 seats. In the row above, total of 13 independent returned candidates were elected in those elections, out of which, in the row above, in the third column from the left, you would see 9 candidates had joined political parties, which then left us with 4 candidates who retained independent status. So in the fourth row from the bottom, the total number of seats for the purposes of distribution of reserved seats were worked out at, so after 272, 3 were stayed or postponed, left us with 269, 13 were independents. You would see 256 is the number which was worked out. This is the number of seats which were secured or won by the political parties. And 9 independents, the total went to 265. Now this is 265 is the number on the basis of which the share of each political parties was then worked out. The quota at the top, above, right
that
above...
That was the total strength of the House?
No, the total strength of the House at the material relevant time was 269. 4 independents were excluded, which then the number which was left was 265. It is this 265 number which was used to determine the quota or the basis for working out the share of each political party. Right above the column,
10 reserve seat kya hai na, ye baaki reserve seat kahan gayi?
Wo agle pages pe aa rahi hai sir. Wo because provinces ka to province by province
chal raha hai. National Assembly mein total reserve seat kitni thi us waqt?
Sir 60 thi, women ki, ye non-Muslims ki 10 seat hai. Main abhi aapko women pe le jaunga because uske liye we have to go through province to province chalna hoga. So ye to hai in total. So 265, up, right above the column you'd see the quota was 265 divided by 10. So against every 26.5 seats, there was one reserved seat for non-Muslims. And then the seats were accordingly distributed amongst the parties which appear in the first 4 rows according to the seats. And in the third column from the right-hand side, you'd see how the seats were then worked out. In the first row, it is PTI, which had a total of 125 general seats. It was divided by 26.5, and the seat was 4.72, and then the highest fraction, it was rounded off to 5, in accordance with Rule 94, and so on and so forth. And then when the last party, which was MMAP, against 12 seats, it got, the fraction was 0.45, but it got rounded off to 1, and they were also entitled to 1 seat. So this is how the formula was applied. The independents were excluded, point being that the independents were excluded. And the following page, page 11, this is now the distribution of seats of National Assembly, women's seats from Punjab. In this case, it was pretty straightforward because out of 141 seats, there were 132 who were elected on political party tickets. They were their candidates or nominees. Seven independents who joined political parties. So the entire 139 was formed the basis. Two results were postponed, which belonged to Punjab. And then this follows at page 12. In page 12, in Sindh, in case of Sindh, one member retained his independent status. He was also excluded. AP, there was no exclusion. In Balochistan, there was one exclusion at page 14. Out of total 16 seats, there was one candidate who was independent. He retained his independent status. You would see on page 14 that the quota was then worked out on the basis of 15 seats. And so on and so forth. Now, if I may take your lordships for a moment to page 4. These are the rules which are called the National Assembly and Provincial Assemblies Allocation of Reserve Seats of Women and Non-Muslims Procedure Rules 2002. Now these are material in two respects.
These have not been repealed.
But sir, I'll come to that because 2017 ne phir inko repeal kiya. Rules 4 and 5 are in pari materia with Rules 94 and 95 of 2017 rules.
Rule 4 is parimateria to
294 and Rule 5 is parimateria with Rule 95. The sub-rule 2 of Rule 5 with one material difference which is not relevant for the purpose of this discussion, this case. At that point in time, I just, for the sake of completeness, under the 2002 rules, my lord, yesterday, when you told me to 95-1, I said that those who will win on two seats will not be excluded for the purpose of working out the share. But under Rule 5, sub-rule 2 of these rules, they were excluded. In addition to the independents, they were also excluded, but this was done away with while making 2017 rules. And under the 2017 rules, it is only the independents who get excluded. My lords, if I may, page 7 pe dekhenge. It must be a folded page, page 7. This is the 2002 assembly, the 12th National Assembly. In this, my lords, at serial number 16, at the bottom, there were 14 independents who had retained their independent status. Out of the House of 272, the results were withheld on two seats. So the 270 was the number. 14 independents, the share was worked out on the basis of exclusion by excluding 14 independents, and it was 256 seats which formed the basis for working out the formula. And at serial number 4 and 5, you'd see there were two parties who had gotten 13 seats each. Whereas the independent, there were 14 independents, but the seat went to one of these two parties because there was a tie and a lot was drawn and it was given to MQM at that time because it was 10th seat. Page 9. Now this is important, but before you turn to page 9, one point I want to make here. The 2002 National Assembly was the assembly in which for the first time, 51-6, the distribution of seats took place under 51-6. This is the assembly which had passed the 17th Amendment. So when we look at the legislative intent, my lords and your ladyship will please bear in mind that the assembly which had passed the 17th Amendment was perfectly okay with the distribution of seats by the exclusion of independents. Every successive National Assembly, the same practice has been followed. At no point in time, either the independents have objected to it or any of the political parties across the aisle have objected to the exclusion of independents. So my lord and your ladyship will bear the legislative intent in mind, what they had in mind while introducing Article 51, Clause 6. Page 9, sir. Now this is Balochistan Assembly. This is relevant only because a large number of independents got returned. More than 20% of that assembly comprised of independent candidates. And at the time when the reserve seats were being distributed, you'd see, sir, the total seats in Balochistan at that time and now also 51. Two seats were taken out because of death, and one returned candidate was appointed as the governor. So 49 seats were the relevant seats, out of which 10 were independents. And the 10 was equivalent to 20.41% of the total. So the distribution of 11 women seats was worked out on the basis of 39 seats, which was by excluding independents, and those 39 seats formed the basis for working out or distributing or for allocating the reserve seats. My point, my lord, as I had submitted yesterday, all along, the independents have always been excluded, and it is quite clear from the text of 51(6) and so also the purpose of it, that seats have to be given to political parties. It is the women whose representation was to be secured through political parties on the basis of proportional representation system of political parties list. The only exception for independents is what is provided in the proviso. My lord, with this, I move on to my next submission. And now here I address the question.
Why such situation is not provided under the Act and the rules?
You pardon me?
To cater such type of situations, why the Act does not provide any provision like this? To give the seats if such a situation of independent candidates occur, and the under the proportional representation system, the seats will go to such parties who have contested.
My lord, that is our...
Well, 51D alone is not enough for this interpretation, you see.
My lord, the rules also provide, sub-rule 2 of rule 95 provides for exclusion of independents 1. With the exception that the independents who duly join a political party, they do not get excluded because they get added back to that political party for the
consequences of exclusion are not mentioned.
My lord, the consequence of exclusion is something which is rooted in 51(6)(d), my respectful submission, which is that because the seats have to be allocated to political parties and not to the independents, therefore the independents must
what
necessarily
be. What is the purpose of list at the time of filing list of the political parties for the reserve candidate? Yes. How do you know that this situation is going to happen? I will give 10 names.
My lord, the...